Far out, jive heads. Are you hip yet? And if not, just put some flowers in your hair and some flowers in your pipe. And suddenly we are in San Francisco during one of those dreamy summers of love, 1967 or 68. And you've started the day with a toke or two, and now you're headed toward the park to see what's happening, and you're grooving on the scene. When suddenly a Volkswagen full of laughing hippies drives by with Sergeant Pepper blasting away on the radio. It's KSAN Jive 95. And suddenly you can't decide whether to spend the day trying to save the world or just savor the world. And so you have another toke. And this is Scoop Nisker trying to remember what it was like 40-some years ago when the world was young. And our magical mystery tour begins a few decades before the summers of love, just after World War II, when America became a superpower, taking over the former European colonies with television and Coca-Cola and dreams too rich to ever be fulfilled. It was an America where the cars had started to grow fins, and the terrorists were known as communists, and the American dream was just starting to put everyone to sleep. And in the heart of the new empire, a bunch of young rogues and visionaries began to articulate a different sensibility, a counterculture, a movement that drew on the ideas of European Dada and existentialism with their declarations of absurdity, a movement that turned to the East, to the Tao, the Buddha, and the Jai Jai Ram, a movement that was fueled by the drumbeats of essential Africa and that found its American voice in the musical forms of jazz and rock and roll, and in the writings of the beatniks. It was the gang of Jack Kerouac, burst upon the scene, mad to live and dig every note in the great riff of life, driven along the road by the crazy looping solos of Charlie Parker. And for anyone like myself, who had always felt like an outsider in America, it was thrilling to read Allen Ginsberg's poem Howl, written way back in 1956, in which he denounced the god of war and commerce that had already begun to take over the soul of this nation. He named that god Moloch. Moloch the Loveless. Moloch, whose mind is pure machinery. Moloch, whose blood is running money. Moloch, whose fingers are 10 armies. But the beatniks were really romantics and mystics at heart. As Ginsberg said, they were beatifically beat. And in their travels, they saw the light come shining down from the lidded eyes of the Buddha. And soon they started introducing strange new words into the hipsters' jive. Words like karma and dharma and mantra and tantra. And it all sounded so exotic, I finally decided to come to San Francisco to become a beatnik. But it was already 1967. Too late to make the scene, man. So I got assigned to the hippies instead. And I am proud to say I was a hippie. Can I get a witness? I was one of those flower children, optimistic, idealistic, walking around in tie-dye, sporting a wild-looking Jufro, and I spent a lot of my time in the late 60s experimenting with consciousness, yes, through drugs, but also through meditation and yoga and the new psychologies of Gestalt and Reichian energetics. And I was part of a vast conspiracy of young people who, at least for a few years, refused to join the Straits and their consumer economy known to us as the system. We rejected the old world mentality of our parents with their depression era fears of scarcity and war and their uptight Puritan morality. Instead, we sought a new consciousness, one that could celebrate life and sexuality and tune into nature and embrace the world as one. Okay, so maybe we were a little naive. Or maybe we just had it too good, as the psychologist Paul Goodman wrote in his famous book, Growing Up Absurd, quote, "It was destined that the children of affluence who grew up without toilet training and freely masturbating would turn out to be daring, disobedient, and simple-minded." End quote. So maybe that's why we started chanting, "We want the world and we want it now." We had bad potty training and became prone to tantrums. But we were trying to create a better world, and also trying to stop our government from conducting a criminal, horrific war. And we held some great protests, like the 1967 March on Washington, where we caused the Pentagon to levitate. That's right, we just surrounded the building and chanted Om, and up it went. On that day, we were super hippies. But at heart, hippies weren't very political. We had no analysis or five-year plan. Instead, our revolution was expressed in gatherings known as be-ins. Communal celebrations of just being. Here's the San Francisco Oracle, a psychedelic journal in the Haight-Ashbury, 1967, announcing the first human be-in taking place in Golden Gate Park. Quote, The spiritual revolution will be manifest and proven. We will shower the nation with waves of ecstasy and purification. Fear will be washed away, ignorance exposed to sunlight. Prophets and empire will lie drying on deserted beaches. Yes, it was a spiritual revolution, and if the hippies have a legacy, it's in the yoga and meditation centers now existing in every town in America, and it's also in the modern environmental movement that got its start in the late 60s, with back-to-the-land visions of ecotopia, plus a whole earth catalog of appropriate technologies now becoming necessary for our very survival. Yes, the hippies were right, jive heads. It's time to scale down and simplify. It's time to recreate community and celebrate existence and make a whole new world, remember, full of peace, love, and good vibes. So in honor of the hippie legacy, I propose that somewhere, maybe on the Mall in Washington, D.C., there should be a statue erected to the unknown hippie. People could visit and leave old buttons, beads, flowers, joints. And however you feel about the hippies today, jiveheads, we sure could use a summer of love in America and in San Francisco right now. So go ahead, turn off that isolating computer with its big brother brain keeping you hyper-busy and distracted, and just go out into the streets and start talking to people about life or how to end all the disgusting wars, or else go to the park and just sit down and feel the earth like the hippies used to do, and then vow to do everything you can to see that our little biosphere project continues here on planet Earth. And then, jiveheads, even if it's just for a few hours, banish your sorrow over what's happening to the world. Let go of the fear and the greed and have yourself a be-in. Celebrate life and the mystery of it all. Celebrate another summer of love. And this is Scoop Nisker, reminding you to stay high but keep your priorities straight. And as always, if you don't like the news, go out and make some of your own.